Welcome back, aviators. We're here in Sydney on this Taper Sky flight to Ayers Rock. Let's get ourselves underway. Bit of background noise, I have to mute the mic a minute. So it's the same flight time as in the region of 3 hours. Yeah, 3 hours. My apologies for a slight delay. Who's this bit behind? Necrontis. Okay, so bit relaxed and try to float, and we'll see you for arrival into Ayers Rock. Okay, welcome back, aviators. We're beginning our descent. And runway 31. Ascending down to 1,700 feet. And begin our descent. Okay, next thing I need to work out is the weather. And there is none. Brilliant. Okay, okay, so from my app. So Kenick, it's 1014 and 014. Temperature is 30 degrees. Magnitude wind is 58 knots. 50/8. Here we go. And our barrow decision height for LFV nav is at 2,000 feet, yeah? 2,000. There we go, flight plan. There. Turn some of these lights off now that we're not going to need. Light down there. Turn that down. Awesome. Sent down to our destination. Yeah, that's why. Let's direct it AY21. Yeah, we're way too high. AY2E. Set AY2E. Set. Very massively. Let's see, speed brakes out. Try and get ourselves back down on profile. But there, we're going to be struggling. Pretty much ride the speed brake the whole way down on this. Not the idea of descent. I tell you what are we gonna do? What are we gonna do to help us get back on track? Is we'll fly a loop turn. Let's reduce that, because that's a ridiculous rate of descent. Take that off, and we'll just fly a loop to get ourselves back on track. It's my own fault for not looking at the flight plan properly. Should have realised that Zodiac paused when I got so close. But, down to 20,000 feet now. So an RNAV arrival. It's going to be fun for this aircraft. Let's lower it down. Close towards the iconic Ayers Rock, or Uluru, as it is more perhaps I guess commonly known as these days. So that should get us back on track now. Just imagine it, we're flying a holding pattern. I mean, I suppose I could have programmed one in, I guess, but it's easier just to do this. So continue our descent down. When I get to about a little lower, and then we'll so the Q&H, can't remember what we agreed that was. I suppose we can turn the heading back now, can't we? Oops. And I've got my arms out. That. Set. Go. Oh. Beautiful. Get back on profile now. Set with brake medium. Rearm the speed brake. We're to keep an eye out for the iconic landmark. It'll be on our left as we come into land. Elevation of the airfield above the actual ground is 1,600 feet. Amazing how red the landscape is this part of Australia, or the world even. It's almost like the surface of Mars, isn't it? Colour-wise. So I have been to this airport before when I did a sightseeing tour. It's my first visit flying something this size, though. this place in reality. Did they take A320s? There we go. Oh yeah, 737s, A320, yeah they do. Cool. I'm going to drop back down onto profile in a minute. So we can get seat signs on and other necessary equipment on. Oops. As we prepare for arrival into slow ourselves down a little bit quicker. Getting ever closer. Still no sign of the rock. As we get closer, as we come into land, I'd imagine we'll see it. In fact, I believe it's just there, through the haze. We need very much to be focused on landing. Pity the passengers on the right side of the aircraft for this one. That is it. Nice to see it again. Can't remember how long ago I flew round it in the biplane. That's quite a while back. There it is, very clear. Very, very clear. Awesome. Fact. Oops. It's almost like it's two of them. Look, there's that one there, and then there's another one further back. Interesting, huh? Skydolly open, what the hell? Need that up and running. There we go. So that's it, Skydolly recording. There's two of them, aren't we? I'm a bit confused now as to which is which. Surely this nearer one is it, right? Totally confused. It's gotta be. Yeah. Pretty confident. Landmark. was slowing down, it slowed down a little bit quicker. Are in sight. What the hell? What are you doing? Get rid of throttle issue, that's not ideal for our approach. Anyway, we will kick the autopilot off in a minute and bring service into land. All the runway is here actually. Sorry, don't we? Let's kick that off now. Did put the gear down, didn't I? Yep. Gear is down. Wind is pretty non-existent. Right about that, it's up a bit, screen a bit low.
Five hundred. 100 above.
Runway looks narrow, doesn't it?
Minimum.
10 years.
Retard. 5.
Oh, we floated it like a pig.
Retard.
Floated that like an absolute pig. How tiny is that taxiway, seriously? I'll tell you what, I'm gonna backtrack this because that taxiway is way too small to be an Airbus down. It's a bloody light aircraft. I pegged wrong the main one, I think. That's too tiny, that's ridiculous. A terrible landing. I really managed to float that out again. Made a bright old hash of it. You just can't land this aircraft nicely. So this runway just for some reason feels narrow. If I'm just imagining things, but it does feel narrow. Anyway, welcome to Ayers Rock. Managed to fluff the landing again, not happy about that. Than smash it. I suppose a float's better than smashing it down, right? And just as I say, I'm still having a hard time landing this plane nicely. That looks a bit wider, doesn't it? Yeah, come on, let's go. Certainly gonna have done that other one, that's for sure. That must just be a static aircraft, because this is obviously a freeware scenery. Must just be a static aircraft. Where are we going to park, actually? Thought about that. Find somewhere over here. So, as we arrive inbound from Sydney. There. Hello. That's taken. Where are we going to park? There's like a ton of there. We're just going to sling it in between these two. And that's not a proper parking spot. What the hell it is now? There we go, it's going there. Sure, the gates are supposed to be here. Right, let's have a look at our landing, shall we? A bit we need to look forward to. Let's just recycle that, make sure it's going to display properly. There we go.
Speed.
So here we are, coming down. Oops. I think the size of the runway threw me off a bit. Hmm. too disastrous, I guess. I mean, it could have been a bit better, but... So that brings us to the end of this flight. I realise you had a choice of flights. Thank you very much for choosing this one. I wish you a pleasant and present journey. Hope to welcome you back on board again very near future. So from here in Ayers Rock, I'm going to leave you with a couple of views of our landing. A few more to enjoy. Almost a perfect landing. Just floated literally inches above the ground as I'm lying. Put the nose down a bit too abruptly as well. Need to get out of that habit. There we go, folks. Let's get to the zoom in thing there. Oops. A little bit further back, perhaps. I like that there. Fabulous. And play. From that view, looks a reasonable landing. I'll pause it there and come around the other way now. Get the view from in front. That's a nice one, isn't it? Wasn't too bad in the end. Certainly we'll finish there. Thank you very much for watching. Well, for now.